So when something goes wrong in our asynchronous code, we should return an error response. To simulate that here, inside the promise, let's define a variable called error is equal to true. And inside the logic, wherever we are implementing logic, we'll do it conditionally. If error, then use the reject call. When reject is invoked, that means there is a problem. If not, resolve. Cut it, paste it inside the else block. So we are simply simulating an error condition here. If there is an error while processing asynchronously, we are using the reject call. Reject is the second parameter. It is a function which tells the JavaScript engine that there is a problem in the asynchronous code. And when we are invoking the promise here, when we get the promise back inside, then we define a second function which can handle the error. Console.log error. Simply display an error message. Save it. Go back to the web browser. Refresh. We have a problem in the syntax. So there is no semicolon right here. They are just two functions. Remove that semicolon. Come back. Go to the console. Refresh. And after 2 seconds, we will see an error coming back. It's working asynchronously. But since we have changed this flag, or we have initialized this flag to true, it will always reject, invoke the reject method to simulate error condition. And when that reject happens, this function here, the second function, will be invoked. Now, if you flip this flag to false, that should return resolve, and you should see the earlier output. Go back, refresh. Now you see work done. So it's that simple to handle resolve or successful responses and error conditions when you are working with promises.